Hey guys, what's up? Aru! Meet the doctor.
Doctor! Are you sure this will work?
No!
Man, Dottore has got to be one of my favorite Harbingers so far. I don't know, the way he's just so unhinged and crazy with all his human experimenting and countless war crimes just puts a big happy smile on my face. But this isn't going to be a simple Dottore video. In fact, this isn't even about Dottore himself. Rather, the clones, puppets, segments, perspectives, these things right here. So welcome to another video of someone who has weird tastes.
Stop it. Get some help.
In this video, we are going to go over why Dottore wanted to make his so-called segments, what he meant by his perspectives, and his plans regarding that, how his segments work based on a certain character as well as a psychological theory, and finally some speculation on what he plans to do with his segments in the future. Timestamps, as always, will be in the description and the comments. So, let's get started. We know that Dottore has or had a handful of segments, not clones, segments of himself. And Dottore made about 7. These 7 segments, he most likely uses to do a multitude of tasks. Traveling the continent, infiltrating different regions, speaking with important people, trading information, and heck, he can play League with himself by himself. But most of all, what he loves to do with all these segments is experimenting. Because if one Dottore can do at least 3 experiments at the same time, maybe even more, imagine if there were 7 or 8 or 9, 10 Dottores. There's no telling how many and to what point this guy already reached in his experiments. He could also use all 7 segments for all 7 regions, while the original Dottore can just go around to Vat and just be an absolute menace. And we've only met at least 2 out of the possible 8 Dottores. We can see the 2 versions from Tinari speaking with Dottore, having a younger tone, and the older version from almost every other scene, and is especially prevalent when he was speaking with Nahida. And the same can be said for Winter Night's Lazo. The voices, however, are basically the same tone, so I can only assume that this is the younger and this is the older through context given by Columbina, even though they sound the same. Something interesting is that Dottore in Sneznaya seems to speak the same lines as the Dottore from Sumeru, which could explain the many segments inside of Dottore's head, meaning that they could all speak to each other even though they are in different locations. Sadly, Nahida made him erase his segments. And Dottore did in fact erase them, all 7 of them. But if you think that deleting all 7 segments as well as Nahida having a bit of a temper tantrum is going to stop our mad scientist, then you have another thing coming, because that won't stop Dottore from making them again. If you have noticed, each of the segments are at a different point in Dottore's life. There's an old man Dottore, a younger Dottore, some in between, and apparently from the CN and the KR versions of the game, one that sounds like this. This is of course still Dottore, but at least a really young Dottore. Now, why would Dottore want a kid segment of himself? In addition, why would he need an old man version when it's more efficient to make 7 relatively strong and competent segments? Well, Timmy, the answer isn't a matter of speed or efficiency as well as power, but rather something he calls perspectives. Dottore said that what keeps him from his experiments is time, but what he really meant was different cognitions from different points in time, because at each point of our lives is a slight change in how we perceive, think, rationalize, and decide. This variation of opinions and ideals is what Dottore actually needs, because if you're the number 2 of all the Harbingers, do you really think that you would run out of grunts to do all your labor work for you? Like, really? One example of how Dottore might use these segments is with the younger segment maybe being more optimistic and energetic about the idea of one experiment, while the other, more experienced and older segment might offer insight as to why such an experiment is a bad idea. And maybe the depressed and angsty Dottore in his teens might say that this idea was bound to fail from the start. All of that leaves the main Dottore to decide based on each of his segment's insights, reasoning, and, you guessed it, perspective. This may not seem like much, but when conducting experiments at such a large scale, even one small error can cause nearly the fall of an entire region or ending up being completely worthless in the long run. So you might as well have as many perspectives and opinions and ideas as possible. And with 7 variations of a mad scientist, you're bound to find at least one, if not the best, solution. Now that we've got Dottore and his segments out of the way, here's where we start taking references from other games as well as an actual psychological theory. And we're gonna use those to make sense of Dottore's segments as well as theorize what else he may do based on these references. Now I have 2 references regarding how his segments work. The first one is gonna be the more fun and energetic bit, and the other is quite a headache. So just pick your poison. Starting off with the more fun and cute way to put Dottore's segments together, but first, disclaimer. I play more Genshin than Honkai. So yeah, that explains every possible missing bit from this Vill-V segment, okay? Thank you. Vill-V, or Vill-5, but I call her Vill-V, is a character from Honkai Impact 3rd, which I don't have. That has somewhat the same segment gimmick as Dottore. But Vill-V has all segments in one body. Vill-V calls her segments personalities, and she has, from my understanding, 8 plus 1 personalities. The plus 1 is the original version, which she almost never uses and is like chilling in a corner of her mind for, I don't know, 50,000 years, I think. These 8 plus 1 all have different abilities, motives, and of course, personalities. The conductor is the closest to the original Vill-V with just a bit more confidence, and is the go-to personality that she uses very often, hence the name. The magician has a more playful, troll, cunning personality. The expert, who is good at doing everything, that she literally does everything, which makes her quite disgruntled. She who looks down upon the stars, which if you could make a guess, is basically Fischl but a bit nerdy. Flavorful is what you get by mixing Sucrose's shyness and alchemy with Shang Ling's ability to cook. The lecturer, who is dead because of a long story with Aponia that I'll talk about in a bit, and the evil Vill-V, who has all her negative thoughts and emotions, basically your intrusive thoughts at 3 a.m. Finally, Kevin Killer Mark 5, which... Now, why did I mention every personality? Well, because this is as close as I can get to explaining Dottore's segments without a long-winded discussion. Because from what I've just said, you can basically maybe infer that Dottore might do something that Vill-V did from Honkai, considering, you know, they're both Hoyo games. But, of course, it's gonna be a bit different. Something interesting and what I think Dottore could do with his segments is that Vill-V can also erase her personalities. And she's the first to do that, not Dottore. By either throwing the personality away somewhere or letting it die, and then basically creating the same personality again. But this is only done by the original Vill-V, from what I could gather. So I'm not so sure if the other 8 Vill-Vs can do it as well. Not only that, she can also keep specific mental experiences, like mind control, and keep it caged in that one personality, making the other personalities unaffected by whatever mind control ability that one personality experienced. Which happened with the lecturer when Aponia, TLDR, wanted to control her, because her power is discipline and she can control things. That's all you need to know about Aponia. By doing this, she keeps all the other personalities safe, while only one personality absorbed everything else and was thrown away and regenerated back again. However, one thing that Vill-V can't do is exceed a certain number of personalities, because the more personalities that she creates, essentially the dumber she gets. Because with all those 8 personalities, her mind can only take so much before losing a few, no, a lot, of brain cells. Now, if we take these traits of Vill-V's personalities and put them into Dottore's segment, then you basically have one Dottore with 9 personalities, which does reflect well with how each segment reacts in his head. With the only difference being, Vill-V didn't make a working copy or clone of herself, and Dottore did, we think. Columbina, however, mentions how Dottore looks and compares him to the older version, making this Dottore burning the urban soul the older Dottore, while the one in Seznaya is a younger Segment, which at least proves that they are in fact clones, and there are two of them. Then again, we still haven't seen this thing happen, as well as seeing two Dottores in the same place, so I guess it's still up to speculation. Now that we're done with the happy, fun, cute version of my theory, let's move on to the brain rot Segment. Eric Erickson. This guy created 8 stages of development, which focuses on conflicts that a person will have to choose between when they are at a certain age. Now remember what I said about Dottore at different stages in his life, as well as having maybe 7 segments based on that cinematic? Yeah, this is where I think Dottore is getting his segments from. Each stage and how they choose is gonna depend on their overall state of mind. Whichever side they choose will be how their personality ends up as. For example, the older Dottore, a more selfish Segment as described by himself, could be in the late adulthood stage and has chosen an ego integrity centric role, making this Segment proud and unashamed of what he wants or says. While the younger Segment might be in his adolescence stage and might have chosen the role of confusion, so he isn't really sure of what he says or if he's doing the right things, as well as being confident and assertive and to the point, which this Segment did not show, apart from having a bit of hot conversation with Tinari. Now, you might have noticed that I'm only making surface level inferences. That's because we can't really determine completely which stage or which role the two Segments we have so far, as well as me not wanting to waste too much of your time saying that each Segment could have chosen one of the 16 choices within the 8 stages of development, and because we've only seen very little screen time of both Segments. Now we're gonna start a bit of comparison, and compared to Vill-V's 8 plus 1 personalities, which is pretty much fleshed out enough that we'd get a clear understanding of how each personality works, with the stages of development, we can't say what type of personality each Segment has just yet. It's also worth mentioning that each Segment does not need to be completed or that they need to be completed in a proper order. So one Segment may not have completed the first 4 stages completely because of how his life might have gone, but have already chosen their role in the other 4. Because of how they've matured, making for a near endless amount of permutations of perspectives that can all offer varying levels of insight. Now, these Dottore Segments can and will prove to do more than what I've said in this video, as well as losing his Segments not really being a problem since he's just received not one, but 2. No sees or no says, and creating more and essentially better perspectives are still on his to-do list. So you already know what's next. But what else is this mad scientist going to do with these 2 gnosis? For one, Dottore can make this huge robot that was empty, and it won't require a pilot to make it work either. Paired with his little hobby of experimenting with both humans and basically everything from the old world, we can maybe predict by combining everything he does, he can make an enhanced cyborg human clone with excessively powerful gnosis-fueled abilities. Which, if you look at the Fatui's countless and sometimes weird skirmishers, he's basically almost there. Or he's already there depending on how far your own speculations about Dottore are. Human cloning is, from what I can understand, banned in Sumeru based on the Academia and Nahida's perspective, but other regions might not be so strict when it comes to morality. So Dottore could also be knee-deep in the next region such as Natlan and especially Fontaine. And Fontaine is honestly the best place Dottore could market his breakthroughs. It's the most technologically advanced, very experiment heavy cyberpunk steampunk dystopian region, so there's bound to be some sort of exploit or a bit of moral ambiguity. Either an exploit in, I can't believe I'm gonna say this, human labor or robotic automation and very questionable experiments. And not gonna lie, Dottore's character would be best done in Fontaine as well. If not, then his partner in crime, Refrigerator, would offer us some insight about him if he already left Liyue. Of course, this is minor speculation and I'm merely pulling really, really short strings of crack thoughts to make a really long crack theory, which is essentially how I do my videos. But sometimes we can't help imagining things, can we? And that's everything I could think of about Dottore segments, what he could do with them later on, and what else he could be planning in the future. Comment below, do you think Dottore is gonna make more than just the first 7 we've seen? Or is his segments basically done for and my dream of seeing 8 Dottores in Fontaine is worthless? So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I've wanted to do this video on Dottore's segments for a while, so yep, there you go. Of course, like and sub if you enjoyed this video and hit that bell to stay updated to every video and stream that I do. This will be a massive start to my simping for Dottore. That said, the other Harbingers are gonna have to wait though, cause I wanna make videos on them as they come out, but man do I wanna see them already. So yeah, thanks for watching, I'll see you guys in the next video, yeah? Like, comment if you enjoyed, subscribe for my rambling, and stay mad theorists. Bye!